Watching Kids Education with Canic. Today I'm gonna read you a story. It's a very interesting story. Most of the kids love story. That's why I'm telling this. So, and it is called Little Red Riding Hood. Well, do you know why this is one of my favorite stories? Because most of the stories only have one moral, but this has two. So we're gonna go ahead and start. Okay. Once upon a time, lived a girl with her mother in the deep, dark forest. They lived in the edge, and her name was Little Red Riding Hood. Do you know what everybody used to call her that? Because she used to wear a little red dress like that and a hood. So that's why her name was Little Red Riding Hood. And one morning, her mother came out with a basket of goodies, like that, and said, "Oh, honey, can you take this goodie basket to your granny?" And her granny lived on the other side. And then she added, "Please, because your granny's not feeling that well, I think that will better cheer her up." Oh, yeah, remember one thing. Stay on the path. Do not talk to any strangers in the way. And then the Little Red Riding Hood said, "Okay, Mama, I will go." Then she headed off. Little Red Riding Hood skipped and hopped. She was only a little way through the forest until a wolf jumped in her way and said, "Hello, my pretty one. Where are you going this fine morning?" He had big, sharp claws and big, shiny teeth. And then the Little Red Riding Hood replied, "To my granny's house? She lives on the other side of the forest." And then the wolf said, "Oh, yeah." And then the Little Red Riding Hood said, "Oh, excuse me, mister, I'm not allowed to talk to any strangers." So then the wolf said, "Oh, I'm sorry." And then he said, "What about take a look at these lovely wild flowers? Maybe that'll cheer your granny up. You can pluck some of them." Until she was plucking the flowers, do you know what happened? The wolf ran away to granny's house. I don't know what will be the surprise next. Let's see. And then she started plucking the flowers. The big, nasty, sly wolf reached to granny's house and knocked on the door. Granny said, "Who is it?" The wolf said in Little Red Riding Hood's voice, so granny won't know that's the wolf. And he said, "It's me, Little Red Riding Hood." The granny said, "Come in, the door is open." Then the wolf came in and saw Granny. He gobbled her in one big gulp. Then the big bad wolf dressed in Granny's dress and tugged in her quilt. Then after some time, Little Red Riding Hood came and knocked the door. Now the big bad wolf said in Granny's voice, "Who is it?" Little Red Riding Hood said, "It's me, Little Red Riding Hood." The wolf said, "The door is opened. You may come in, just like Granny." And then the Little Red Riding Hood came in. She stepped in the house. Little Red Riding Hood says, "Oh, what big eyes you have, Granny." The wolf said, "Just to see you better, my dear. Come a bit closer." And then Little Red Riding Hood comes a bit closer and says, "Oh, what big ears you have, Granny. Just to hear you better." And then she says, "What big teeth you have, Granny. And then the wolf gulps Little Red Riding Hood, just like Granny. Now the wolf has gobbled Granny and Little Red Riding Hood, both of them. Soon, a woodcutter came. He was off for work. Just looked in Granny's window to see if she was feeling well or not, and saw the wolf. And he knew just what happened because to see Wolf's big fat tummy. Then he comes in the house and cuts the wolf's tummy in half. And then jumped out Little Red Riding Hood and Granny. And then the woodcutter dragged the wolf to a deep hole with water in it. And he dropped the wolf right in and said, "Bye-bye, nasty wolf." Soon, Little Red Riding Hood said, and Granny, "Thanks for saving us." So now we read a book, and now it's time for me to tell two morals to you. First one, we should always follow what our parents say. Second one, we should never talk to strangers in the path. I hope you liked this story, Little Red Riding Hood, and bye!